This question is about colligative molality and how it affects three colligative properties: vapor pressure, boiling point, and freezing point. So we're given the colligative molality of an aqueous solution as 1.23 molal. Our first question says, what is the vapor pressure of the solution at 30 degrees Celsius? And we're given the information for pure water at 30 degrees Celsius, the vapor pressure is 31.8 torrs. Okay, well, let's think of the formula. The vapor pressure, according to Raoul's law, is going to be equal to the mole fraction of water in the solution times the pure vapor pressure of water. Well, we know the first part of this, right? We know the pure vapor pressure of pure water is 31.8 torr. Now I just have to figure out the mole fraction. Okay, and this is going to be a units conversion. We are given molal and we have to get to mole fraction. Let's remind ourselves of what molal is. This is 1.23 moles of solute in 1,000 grams of water. Okay, so if we were to take 1,000 grams of water, we know for sure we'd have 1.23 moles of solute, and we'd have 1,000 grams of water. Wouldn't it be nice if we knew how many moles of water that was? Let's find out. 1,000 grams of water, and we will divide by the molar mass of water, 18.02 grams of H2O per 1 mole of H2O is equal to 55.49 moles of H2O. Okay, so the mole fraction of water is going to be equal to the moles of water over the moles of water plus moles of solute. Okay, well, we know those values. We know that water is 55.49 moles when our solute is 1.23 moles. So our mole fraction is 0.9784. Hopefully that makes sense to you. The solution is mostly water, so the mole fraction ought to be pretty high and close to 1. Okay, now we know the mole fraction of water, so we'll just bring that value back up here and say 0.9784 times the vapor pressure of pure water, and it is 31.1 torr when you multiply it out. Okay, part B of this question says, what is the boiling point of the solution? And we're given the information KB is equal to 0.512 degrees Celsius per molal. Okay, well, remember that this is boiling point elevation, right? And the formula is the change in boiling point from where it would be for a pure solution is equal to IKBM. What you may not realize is that rearranging this, KB times I times M, I times M is actually the value we've been given, the colligative molality. So KB is 0.512 degrees Celsius per molal, and our colligative molality is 1.23 molal. We'll multiply that out, and we find that the value is 0.6297 degrees Celsius when our units cancel out. Now, first thing about sig figs, looks like we need 3 of them. Okay, So we're going to elevate the boiling point by 0.630 degrees Celsius. Okay, I hope you know the boiling point of water. That would be 100 degrees Celsius, right? And we'll just add the 0.2630 degrees Celsius and find that the boiling point has been elevated to 100.630 degrees Celsius. Okay, last part of this. What is the freezing point of the solution? It's the same formula, except it is freezing point depression. So it gets lower. So delta TF is equal to I KF molality. And again, we'll just rearrange this, and IM, the Van 't Hoff factor times the molality, is actually what we're given, colligative molality. So we know that 1.86 degrees Celsius per molal is the freezing point depression factor, and our molality is 1.23 molal. And multiplying this out, we will discover that it is 2.288 degrees Celsius. Again, looks like sig figs are going to give this 2.29 degrees Celsius. Once again, I hope you realize the freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius, and this is freezing point depression, so we're going to subtract 2.29 degrees Celsius and discover that our water freezes at minus 2.29 degrees Celsius. Okay, that's three colligative properties.